Hello students, looking at current affairs for 22nd May, the news items picked up from the Hindu newspaper are these six. We'll look at them in detail. The first one, Amphan kills 72 in West Bengal, brings life to a halt. So we saw the detail regarding cyclone Amphan. It struck West Bengal coast and the death toll here has now increased to 72. The chief secretary of West Bengal has said that 2,400 people were evacuated and kept in 3,228 cyclone shelters and other buildings. All fishermen were brought back from the sea. You should know the chief secretary, he is the topmost administrative officer in a state. The way we have a cabinet secretary, who is an IS officer, topmost officer at central level, that is the highest post you can reach as an IS officer. So similarly, at the state level, it is the chief secretary. Then next is PLA blocking Indian patrols in Ladakh, Sikkim, says Ministry of External Affairs. So New Delhi has now rejected Beijing's China's claims that Indian troops are trespassing into Chinese territory, because we have seen skirmishes along the line of actual control, LAC, which is the border between India and China, but it is not agreed on by both sides, because the line which has divided India and China is actually through a commission set up by Britishers. It was the McMahon line. So that McMahon line is not accepted by China. It is said to be unilaterally done by British Indian administration when at the time of independence partition. So this actually has resulted in China not accepting line of actual control, and we are seeing that we have had skirmishes. And India also rejected them, saying that they are local level skirmishes which would be resolved at that level. But now, when Chinese foreign ministry gave a statement that Indian troops are trespassing into Chinese territory, so now Indian authorities have also rejected China's claim and accused China, on the other hand, China's People's Liberation Army, of hindering normal patrols by Indian soldiers in the region. So this is escalation of tensions now being seen. We'll see how that is resolved. Then next is, government announces price range based on duration of flights. So yesterday in news we saw that how government has allowed domestic air flights, and 33% of the means 33% capacity would be allowed, in the sense that airlines would be allowed to fly 33% of their flights. But then within the flights there will be no seats left vacant. So all seats can be filled with precautionary measures being taken. And here you can see with masks and etc. to be used as such as precaution. But the government had also said that we'll set limits to price airfare tickets. So here center has now given a price range for airfare tickets. It has been announced. So flight duration will decide the range of the air ticket, the cost which it would be charging. So commercial airlines are resuming operation on 25th May, and seven categories of airfares have been announced by the government. Ministry of Civil Aviation. So from flights of less than 40 minutes, it is the lowest range, to highest categories of the longest domestic flight of up to 210 minutes. So here you can see this is the seven sectors and the minimum maximum fare which has been announced, right? So there is a range which has been announced, means minimum fare 2000 to maximum fare 6000. So this 2000 to 6000 range is for sector A, which is for 40 minutes flight, and sector G, the last one, is of 210 minutes, where the range is 6500 to 18600. So airlines will have to sell 40% of the tickets below the midpoint of this range, means midpoint to 2000 6000 is 4000. So the 40% of the tickets should be sold below 4000, so that benefit of this formula is passed on to the passengers. So minimum fare for Delhi to Mumbai, it's set to minimum would be 3500, maximum up to 10000. So this is there. And it is said passengers would neither be able to avail themselves of meals services on board, nor would they be allowed to consume their own eatables. So that has also been announced, unless they have specific medical need. So 210 minutes come up to, which is the maximum time, comes up to, you can see, 3.5 hours. So during that time frame, you cannot have any meal abroad, on the meal aboard. And also, there are guidelines that health protocols which have to be followed, means after the passengers are reaching the destination airport, will there be mandatory quarantine for them 14-day quarantine at the end of each journey. On this, the Ministry of Civil Aviation was not clear. It said that health protocols as prescribed by destination states, union territories will be followed. So, that has been announced. Then next is, Health Ministry plans to study viral behavior in corpses. So, senior health officials have now confirmed that India is planning to initiate a study on behavior of COVID-19 virus in persons who died after contracting the disease. So, autopsy actually in confirmed COVID-19 cases is not recommended by Health Ministry, and this research is being conducted by AIIMS, All India Institute of Medical Science, which is the first such study being undertaken on a COVID-19 dead body. So, the guidelines as such, ICMR had, the Indian government had given guidelines that forensic autopsy should not be done because a mortuary staff would be exposed to potentially dangerous health risks due to organ fluids and secretions even after taking the highest precautions. But then autopsy procedure if undertaken is to be strictly limited, and whatever is necessary for research work concerned can be done. So, that would be undertaken now by Indian government. Also, with respect to testing, ICMR, Indian Council of Medical Research, has recommended TrueNAT COVID-19 test as such for the disease, because there is a global shortfall of diagnostic supplies and indigenous production has to be strengthened of diagnostic material to ensure uninterrupted availability of tests. Then next is, Odisha adopts contract farming system. So, Odisha government has promulgated an ordinance because parliament is not functioning. So, an ordinance has been promulgated which will allow investors and farmers to enter into agreement for contract farming. So, contract farming has been announced, we have seen, under the Atmanirbhar Bharat Yojana as such too. And now, Odisha government has promulgated an ordinance on this. So, there are uncertainties due to the pandemic. So, this contract farming would facilitate both farmers and sponsors to develop mutually beneficial and efficient contract farming system to improve production and marketing of agricultural produce too, and farmers' interests would also be promoted, is what the state says. But it has made clear, state government has also made clear, that there will be no title, rights, ownership or possession of land or any other such property transferred or alienated or vest in the sponsor or successor or any agent. It will stay with the farmers. So, precautions are also being undertaken. And lastly, there is, China plans security law for Hong Kong. So, China's parliament is now considering to initiate a bill that could limit opposition activity in Hong Kong. So, we have seen in Hong Kong, protests had taken place last year. There were widespread protests which took place on a legislation which was calling for Hong Kong civilians to be trialed and, you know, their trial will be undertaken in China. So, they can be sent to China and, you know, as such for conviction, etc. So, that was actually protested against, and we saw widespread protests taking place for months. And now, you can see, amidst the pandemic, we had seen earlier in news, this month only, in May 2020, that how now Parliament of, means the legislative body of Hong Kong is planning to initiate a bill to ensure that the national flag and anthem of China is respected. It was for the national anthem of China. So, such laws which punish disrespecting the national flag and anthem have been proposed by China. In the legislature, there are pro-Beijing members in Hong Kong legislature as well as pro-democracy members. So, opposition are the pro-democracy members and they have been opposing such bills. But now, Chinese parliament is considering a bill which will actually sidestep legislative body of Hong Kong, and a legislation would be enacted to crack down on activity Beijing considers subversive. So, Hong Kong is a special case for China because Hong Kong was actually governed by British. It was a British colony and was handed over to China in 1997. So, they have more democracy and freedom as such compared to mainland China. But China believes in one country, two systems, and Hong Kong has special rights and it has been assured these special rights when Britain returned it to China in 1997. But it has finally to be, brought into Chinese system, so that eventually is what China wants. Though actually the proposal was that gradually more democratic rights would be provided and Hong Kong would be a democratic region. So here you can see, so there was a legislation earlier also which Chinese parliament had proposed in 2003 under Article 23 of Basic Law, means Hong Kong's mini constitution, actually allows Chinese Parliament to pass a bill for the legislative on behalf of the legislature of Hong Kong. But then they have a widespread protest even in 2003, and the proposal was withdrawn. And now another step has been taken, that China is increasingly pushing for measures such as punishment for disrespecting the Chinese national flag and anthem, and increased pro-China patriotic themed education in schools is being pushed by China in Hong Kong. But opposition in Hong Kong's Legislative Council has made it unlikely that such a bill could be passed at the local level. So this is regarding one country, two system of China too. The constitutional principle created by Deng Xiaoping, the former president of premier of China in 1980s, for reunification of China. So claim is that there is only one China, but distinct regions like Hong Kong, Taiwan, Macau. So Macau was also a region under Portuguese rule and has been handed over to China. Taiwan has been also a disputed region. The government in China in 1950s at that time moved into Taiwan and formed a government in exile, controlling China. But China got the Communist Party got hold on mainland China, and Taiwan has been reduced to that region now, here in the South China Sea, in this region, East China Sea region. And also, China claims that Taiwan also belongs to itself. We are seeing presently also how Taiwan's membership to various international organizations is opposed by China, even at the World Health Organization. It was the recently news. So that is there. So that is one country, two systems principle, and one China policy which China believes in. So that is it. Thank you.